Listen, it's still going to take us a few minutes to do an adequate sound check. I know that it's cold out there, it's cold up here too, but I want to make sure that what we do for you sounds like music and not like noise. So if you'll be patient, I'll try and make this as entertaining as possible as we get the sound balance. Now, how close are we to taking a level on the roof? Can you hear that out there?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jay Migliori. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, customer number two, Mike Altschul. Just let me know when it gets out there.
You want it now?
Okay. Ray Reed. That ain't Ray Reed. It's Charles hooked up. Charles Owen. All right. Joanne McNabb. Can you hear that? Okay. Earl Dumbler.
He's out tight getting those ducks.
That's not very loud, is it?
No!
Get Earl louder. Play some more. Okay, good. Jerry Kessler. Keep playing, Jerry. Keep playing, Jerry. Can you hear him yet? Okay, let's check the brass microphones and then we'll come back to Ray Reed. Malcolm McNabb. Sal Marquez. Tom Malone. Test your front mic, Tom. Okay, Bruce Fowler. Glenn with two N's, Ferris.
What's that, Brian?
Kenny Liquid Delight Schroyer. Ray, are you hooked up yet? Okay, still not hooked up. Let's see. Let's try Tony Duran. Can you hear that? Okay, Dave Parlato on bass. Is that getting out there? All right. Yes, no?
No!
Yes, okay. All right, now Ian Underwood.
I won.
Try some more. All right, now we're gonna try the percussion section and see if that's working. Tom, you try a couple minutes. All right, this is Ruth Underwood on marimba. Okay, try the bongos and timbales. That's good. Temple blocks. More on the temple blocks. More. Try the piccolo snare and field drum. That's okay. Okay. Try the concert bass drum. Turn that one up. Bass drum is coming up. up the knob on the mixer for the bass drum. So I'm all wet. Okay, increase that channel a little bit. Okay, here's the vibe. Are the vibes audible out there? No? Can you hear the vibes yet? Okay, try the congas. Relax. Timpani. Can you hear the timpani? Well, turn them up then. Is that audible yet? More?
Yes!
Does that sound like a kettle drum to you? Well, it sort of does. The gong. Can you hear the gong? Sure we didn't forget anybody up here. Jim Gordon on drums. Let's see if he's coming out.
Hey!
Is that loud enough? More? Boost that up, Paul. More on the kick drum. That's not too bad. Okay, can I get an E? Can you hear that? That's Ray Reed, and there he is live in person. All right, the last thing we're going to do before we play is to have everybody hit an A up here and see if you're in tune. Woodwind instruments and stick them in this temperature, they have a tendency to fluctuate in pitch. We hope that this stays in tune throughout the performance. We'll check periodically. Meanwhile, the name of this song is Big Swifty.
Thank you. Thank you. you don't mind, we're going to try something a little bit stranger than that. Some of you may find this too peculiar. However, we have a piece called
The Adventures of Gregory Peccary, which is a story of Gregory, who is a nocturnal, gregarious wild swine, and he's part of an endangered species that ranges somewhere between Texas and Paraguay, sometimes as far west as Catalina, although that might not mean too much to you. A peccary is a little pig about this big that they chop up and make gloves out of. This pig happens to work at a place called Big Swifty and Associates, which is the trendmonger establishment that services the entire earth. And Gregory is a copywriter at this place, and it's his job to invent trends to be inflicted on bored, miserable people everywhere. One of the things that Gregory has invented for your edification is the calendar, which happens in the second movement. After he invents the calendar, and everybody has a good time with it at the office, having birthday parties and standing around the water cooler and taking their birth control pills with it, in the third movement, Gregory is attacked by a rage of hunchmen through the short forest on his way home from the office. The hunchmen do not wish to know how old they are, and they are protesting the existence of the calendar. In the fourth movement, which is subtitled The New Brown Clouds, Gregory, mystified by the attack of the hunchmen, decides to find out what's going on by inquiring from the greatest philosopher known to mankind, whose name is Quentin Albert de Nameland. There's no narration provided with the presentation that we're going to do now, although it was originally designed that way, so you'll just have to sort of imagine how the proceedings are going to go. In the first movement, Gregory is waking up and being sung to by the posters on his wall, and also driving through traffic, and I'll try and put some other information in between as we go along.
Thank you.
Gregory is about to invent the calendar. He was just attacked by the Hunchman. Now it's time for the brown clouds. Oh.
We hear a big buzz in the PA system up here. Is it coming out there?
Yeah!
It's being caused by the dimmers on the lights up here. Is there anything you can do about it? Think it over.
Thank you. The name of this piece we're going to get out for you right now, it's called Dog Beat. It contains two easily recognizable themes from the
Uncle Meat album. The Dog Breath Variations and the Uncle Meat theme song.
Thank you. for one more piece. I'd like to dedicate this piece to Mrs. Herod, the lady who runs the Albert Hall, the lady who kept us out of the Albert Hall. This is the piece that we were going to play that kept us out of the Albert Hall. If any of you know the words to this song, you can just hum right along to yourself. This is a note to the sound man. Bruce Fowler is going to play the solo in this. Thank you.
Thank you. Goodbye.
As they go to the dressing room, please, Frank Zappa and the Hot Laughs on this one. As you know, we unfortunately don't have time for more. We're going to change in a minute to the other side of the stage, where we have for you, of course, Hawkwind. I'd like to take this opportunity to give you something which might warm you up a little, some news, something we're having happening in the future. On September the 30th, here at the Oval. Incidentally, talking of Oval, we've lit one or two fires and we're running a bit late, but once again they've tolerated us. And I think for the people in the white flannels and striped blazers at the back, how about showing our appreciation for the people that let us come here? Thank you very much. Anyway, on September 30th, we've been able, with the association of Mr. Michael Alfandari, Harvey Goldsmith, John and Tony Smith, and all sorts of professional promoters, in association with the Belly to Make a Pole, which they have every year, we have a group which has done something that no other group has ever done before. That includes the Beatles. They've won 7 number ones and 2 number twos. We have a feature here with some incredible ideas. Emerson, Lake and Parker for you.